Hey everybody, Automatormc. Time for another Factorio tutorial. Late game ore. And it's really actually quite simple if you have some blueprints made up. Your rail that is going around your world, if you have a three-way intersection, you just plop it on where you want to put your ore mine. And then have these schematics, different choices of smelters. Now you want to smelt it at the ore, because ore only stacks to 50, but iron plates and copper plates and that stack to 100. So you can get a lot more on a train, just way more efficient. This is late game. Early on game, you probably want to just ship the ore, but it's essential late game. So I have, it's been a while since I've played, so I gotta find the right parts. I got this separated just so I can bring it closer to the ore. The ore happens to be quite a ways away from the main road, but you could have it this as one blueprint if you wanted. This is your standard station, my standard station, I guess. There's different ways of doing it. What I have here is a programmable speaker. And these are just sensing the items that are on this belt right here. And you can change this to whatever you want. Copper plates, coal, it doesn't matter. When the items equal zero, an alarm will sound and a signal will go off on the map so you'll be able to find it. And that just means that this station is out of ore. Now I have these three blueprints here. Why these are separate blueprints is because if there's obstacles in the way, like a lake or something like that, I can just rotate it and put it like this and just connect the belts. But most of the time I can just plug it in right here. So this is a two smelter array. And then I come from the ore field and plug directly into that. This is a three smelter array. It's facing the wrong way. There we go. And I just plug that in right there. And for the very big ones, I have to delete half of this. And then it includes that half. So I just put the new one, see, on here. And that's the biggest fields. And that way I have six inputs, six smelter arrays. And that is pretty much it. If we look at ore fields that I have around, this is just a four array. This one's getting down there a little bit. It's another small one. I'm gonna find a big one. Oh, there's one more thing I need to add. This is a large array here with six inputs. This field is starting to get low. What I do with my miners is I put a speed beacon on it and then two efficiencies. So it brings it, it's still not as efficient as it would be with none of these modules in it, but it is a lot more efficient than with a speed module alone. And I do this, otherwise I'd be building nuclear power plants forever. So this takes down the load, and speed is what you want, because you have this researching, it's been so while since I played, mining productivity. This is where you get all your productivity from. That's the best way to go there. So if you put speed, that's what you're lacking is speed. You can add that. And the reason I put that on there, obviously you don't need it right now, but when this gets down to just a few are left, it'll still keep up. The speed will help us there. At this point right now, it's kind of meaningless, but yeah. And those efficiency modules, as you can see how many nuclear reactors I have going here just to keep things going. That could be another tutorial. Anyway, that's it for the mining tutorial in Factorio late game. All right, see ya.